This is a public university and free speech. You don't need to sign up or get approval for free speech.
Free speech don't work on a private?
This is not a private university. This is the University of Georgia, a publicly funded state college.
Is that what I ask you?
Well, I'm just letting you know, I do this for a living. This is what I do. If this were a private university, I would need to get permission. Yes, sir. Have I done something illegal?
Well, what each institution is different.
Well,
You to leave and you don't leave, you've done something illegal.
Yeah, and if you're going to arrest me if I don't leave.
I want you to leave.
There might be some people want me to stay, you know. My wife might want me to stay. She's an American citizen. We have free speech. He wants me to stay. What's that?
That's your wife?
That's my wife.
Put down your camera, man. You don't have permission to video on this.
Well, the question is, will y'all arrest us if we stay?
Well, we're going to ask you to leave. And if you want.
I understand that.
Yeah.
So, if will you arrest us if we. You know, I'm not the one speaking, really.
Yeah, but I'm saying, but you're.
You need to deal with my husband on that.
But I'm saying, you're his spouse.
But I'm not. If you were to press any charges on anybody, I'm not even the one speaking. I'm not even.
But you're not here with your husband?
Sure, I'm here with him, but I'm not the one speaking. He's the one that y'all need to talk to, you know? I mean, can students video each other on this campus? Or can you video the crowd or something? You cannot video anybody on this campus without approval. No one can pull out a camera on this campus and video the campus.
It's okay, but you can't video other people.
You can't video other people. So, y'all don't have freedom of press here.
So.
That's part of the First Amendment, right? The freedom of religion, freedom of speech, freedom of press.
Yes. So the thing is,
you people know
y'all are friends of other people's
right
rights too.
Well, they have the right to leave.
Yeah.
They have the right. They don't see. We're not holding them down in here. They're free to all call.
Well, the Bible says, John 7:24, these are not my children.
What'd you say? Number one, I'm telling you what the Bible says. I am not the one making the decision.
The two men sitting on the background are police officers who see this student obstructing my view while recording me with his cell phone. And yet, they say nothing to him about it. Non-controversial speech does not need to be protected. And I'll say it again, non-controversial speech does not need to be protected. Therefore, the speech that is protected in the First Amendment is speech that others may disagree on. Simply wishing somebody to be silent because we do not agree with their views is violating this right. The way to win in the arena of ideas is not to silence your opponent, but to make sure that your voice is louder and more sensible than theirs. Unfortunately, the problem with the church is that it is much too silent in our day. Free speech is just like anything else. If we don't use it, we'll lose it. The church has the truth, the Holy Spirit, and all of God's angels ready to back her up. Unfortunately, she is just unwilling to go to the highways and the hedges, and we will pay a very costly price for this if we don't change. There's a quote that says, "All that is necessary for the triumph of evil is that good men do nothing." God bless.